Welcome back, everyone. The iOS 16 has been released for a while now. The new wallpaper, the depth effect, and other new features are great. But have you noticed that the iOS 16 battery drain issue is more significant than before? So, today I'll show you guys some battery drain issue proof tips. Most of the tips are turning off some feature option. I will briefly introduce these options, and I will rate these tips, so you can decide whether to use these tips or not. Let's go. Before we start, I recommend restart your iPhone if you didn't turn off your iPhone for a while now. It's better restart your iPhone monthly or weekly for once. Offloading those system caches will make your iPhone faster, and maybe even save some battery. Then we can proceed. First thing first, close the apps on App Switcher and turn background apps refresh off. Left apps in the background will still receive and refresh in the background, so turn the apps you don't need off on the switcher. The background apps refresh is the same thing. Go to the settings page, general, background apps refresh. Turn the apps you don't need off. It could save a lot of battery. Also, on the top option, here I recommend you choose only WLAN, because Wi-Fi is more stable than cellular data. It will be less battery use to refresh the background apps. Next, turn off some location and system services. Go to settings page, scroll down, tap the privacy and security option. Let's get into location services first. Here are the apps that need to access your location. If you authorize them always, they will constantly access your location in the background. So I recommend allowing them access only while using. Then tap the system services option. There are a lot of options that you can choose to turn off. Apple Pay merchant identification, cell network search, compass calibration, device management, HomeKit, location-based alerts, location-based suggestions, and so on, all these, you can choose to turn off. And below the product improvement, turn off these three options. So far I didn't see these three options can improve my user experience. Then go back settings page, in the sounds and haptics option, find keyboard feedback. Here have an option named haptic. This makes you feel much better when typing on an iPhone, but it also consumes a lot of battery. So turn it on or off is up to you. Then go back to the settings page again and scroll down, find mail. Tap account and fetch new data. Here I recommend turn off push if you didn't use mail a lot. Cause if it is on, it will constantly push new emails to you. And it takes a lot of power. And below fetch, mail will check if there is a new email in the background from time to time. So I choose every 1 hour, or you can choose manually. It's up to you. The less minutes, the more power need. Now the below tips are not that saving battery, and some of them are only available on some iPhone models. Go to settings page, accessibility, motion. Turning on reduce motion could save you some battery, but not that significant, and you might not get along with the motion. Limit frame rate option, you can turn it on, but I don't recommend it. Once you use the high refresh rate for a while, your eyes are very hard to get back to the low refresh rate. Go back, tap display and text size. Scroll to the bottom, make sure your auto brightness is turned on, or you might maximize your brightness and forget to bring it back. It will consume a lot of battery. If your iPhone supports the always on display feature, you should notice that this feature takes a lot of power too. According to other people's test, AOD on will take 1 to 3% per minute more battery usage than AOD off. But this feature is so cool, so I don't recommend you turn it off. The iOS 16 new lock screen is cool. Lock screen widget is very useful. But if you use some location needed widget like weather or something, it will constantly need to access data. So it will take some battery. I recommend use some simple widgets like calendar. Besides these settings, I recommend you don't use an off-brand USB cable. If the cable quality is bad, it might damage your iPhone battery. And try to keep your iPhone at a normal temperature as well, because high temperatures also damage your iPhone battery. Above are battery improved tips. The reason cause iOS 16 battery drain issue so significant is the iOS 16 system itself. So as long as Apple doesn't come up with a new iOS system to fix this issue, there is not much we can do. But what we can do is refresh the system or upgrade your iPhone when Apple come up with a new iOS. So here I recommend you use Tenorshare Reiboot. This is an iOS system repair tool. It can fix more than 150 iOS issues. So it also can reduce the iOS 16 battery drain issue in some way. You can check the download link in the description if you are interested. Once installed, connect your iPhone to your PC or Mac and open Reiboot. Click the green start button. Choose standard repair here so that you won't lose any data. Then click download to download the firmware that needed. The download will not be long, depending on your network condition. Once the download is okay, click start standard repair. Reiboot will begin to improve the iOS 16 battery drain issue. This also could be used to upgrade your iPhone. It will take a while, be patient. Then it is done. You can see my iPhone iOS system has been refreshed, and the iOS 16 battery drain issue is not that serious now. Go try it. Okay, that's it. Hope this video could help you. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. See you guys next time.